So Canva had their Canva Create event recently and unveiled a whole bunch of new features. In this video, I'm going to share with you five of those that I think are very important that you can use for print on demand. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna talk about Canva and some of the new features that Canva came out with. Now, I'm not gonna go over all the different features. I'm gonna show you where to find those. But in this one, I'm gonna pick out five that I think are really important to print on demand, and I'm gonna share them with you. I'm gonna show you how to use them in Canva so that you can use them and you can go and try them out on your own. So let's not waste any time and get into Canva right now, and I'll show you what they are. All right, so here we are on Canva, canva.com, and you can see they added a little magic to here just because their Canva Create is all about magic and making things happen. You can see a bunch of new features right here on the top. Discover the magic from Canva Create. You can also watch the whole thing. So if you click on here, watch the event, you can watch the highlights right here. You can watch the full thing, and they kind of give you step by step on what some of these things are. So we're gonna go through some of these, but if you wanna go through your own and watch these or play with these, you can. I'm not gonna touch on all of them. It would take a long time to go through all of them, but I did find five that I really like. So let's go back here to Canva. So I'm gonna open up this project here. We're gonna start with gradients, and that's a really cool feature. So the first one I wanted to talk about is gradients. And so gradients are kinda limited right now. So let me show you what it does. So gradients, they're pre-canned gradients right now. So if you click on a shape, you can come in here and there are some gradient colors. So let's try them out. So you can see here, you can change them to different colors. I just put the Canva logo in there. You don't have to, but I thought it was fun to try the Canva logo in there. You can also do it on backgrounds. So come here, I'm clicking the background, which is white. I can change the background colors too. The nice thing about the shapes is that you can turn the shapes, right? So if you don't want your gradient that way, you can do it this way and that way and whatever way. And you can also change the shape. So if I wanted this to be a different shape, I come here to my shapes and it could be a circle or this shape or this shape, or whatever shape you want it to be. Now, in the tutorial, in the conference, they said you can come in here and make your own gradients. I wasn't able to find that yet. I believe it's going to be in the brand hub, and I haven't been able to do the colors. If you know where to do that, maybe I'm not looking in the right place, let me know in the comments. But for right now, these are your gradients. And how would you use it in print on demand? Well, I would not do the background color gradient, but these would make some really cool stickers, right? And you put a silhouette over it or something like that, I think could be really good for stickers, as well as like, if you had another shape here and then did a different shape, let's do, come in here, and this could be some kind of retro thing, right? Maybe this is a line instead of solid, right? So you can see how I'm doing some kind of like 80s retro stuff with gradient and things like that. So I think gradients could really help. Again, when you start to create your own gradients, I think that would be really cool, as well as when you can add these to other stuff. So right now it's just shapes and backgrounds, but can you imagine adding it to silhouettes and other things, or combining stuff and making the whole thing a gradient like I showed in some of my tutorials. I think this is the start to something really powerful, so I wanted to share it, and that is gradients. So the next one I wanted to talk to you about is layers. Now, I think Canva should have had layers a long time ago. I'm glad they have it. Other applications, graphic applications, have layers. If you go to Affinity Designer, Kittle, Photopea, they all have layers. Canva didn't have it. And so it was really hard to figure out what was above each other, where to put each other, and kind of, you could move back and move front, but you really didn't know. And if you had a bunch of layers, you didn't know where they were. So here's how you use layers. You can see I have these different things here. I can see that is in the back, and that is in the back. So red, blue, yellow, like that, right? But let's say they're on top of each other like this, and you wanna grab that one, and sometimes it's really hard, especially if it's not a clear shape. Well, you can come in here and do position. So now, along with arrange, which we already had these kinds of things, we can go to layers. This is new. So now, because they're all together, you can move them up, so, or move them down. Layers right here is the very top and this is the background. But if I wanted to move this above, you can see it does it right there. If this one right here wants to go above it, you can do it right there. What this is, this overlapping one, is because they're all overlapping, they're on here, but let's say you only have two here and you can't pick the one in the bottom, like they cover each other, right? You wanted to get that, one, but you can see I can't. The before layers, there wasn't a really good way to pick that square, because when I tried to pick it, I'm actually picking that. But here with overlapping, you can see, oh, it's overlapping. I can just move it, right? So really nice. And you may not know that something's behind. That's another good thing for overlapping. You can, if it's totally covering it and you didn't know it was there and you click on it, you can see, well, there's actually something behind it, right? So I think this is really powerful, especially, I mean, I did it really simple here, but if you have a complex project that has multiple layers, 20 layers, 10 layers, and you have a hard time trying to pick something really small in it, you can go here to overlapping or to all and just move things around in the space. So very cool. I think this will help a lot for people who are designing, especially t-shirts, when there's a lot of layers on your design. So probably one of the biggest improvements, one of the most asked for features in Canva, and so glad that we have it now, and that is layers. So the next thing I wanted to talk to you about is Magic Eraser. So this one's pretty cool. It only works on a photo. So you can click on here and you can see if it says edit photo, then you can use it. It doesn't work on graphics or shapes or anything like that. It has to be a photo. So here's what it does. Let's say you have a photo, but you don't want this butterfly here. It's sticking out. It's not symmetrical. You just want to get rid of it. Well, before you couldn't get rid of it, you'd have to color it or something like that, but with Magic Eraser, you can. So the way to use the Magic Eraser is to come in here, hit Edit Photo, and you can see you have Magic Eraser and Magic Edit. I'm not gonna do Magic Edit yet, but I will do Magic Eraser. I'll click on here, and we're gonna make it a little smaller so you can see. And I'm just gonna like brush over this butterfly here. And then hit edit photo. Oh, it's just thinking. I don't think I have to do anything. And then it's gone, right? So, and then I go back. So now that I'm back, you can see the butterfly is gone, totally erased. And so it works on different things. So if you wanted to get rid of his ears, for example, you could. It doesn't work like very well. Like if I wanted to get rid of this flower, maybe we could try it. Let's see what kind of results we have. So let's go back, edit photo. Let's say we wanted to get rid of just this flower. Let's see how good it is. Not bad, not bad. It's trying to clone it here. You can see, maybe if I do it again, let's try that. No, I think I freaked it out. No, I did it. Wow, look at that. I brushed that flower away. That's pretty cool. So I come back in here, still transparent, you can see, but we took that flower away and took that butterfly away with the Magic Eraser. So it kind of knows the background and then fills in, you know, if it's a transparent background, it'll keep it transparent. If it has a color in the background, then it knows to fill that color with the right color to make it go away. So you probably could take away the dots on here if you wanted to. Take away his ears or whatever it is. So have fun with this one. This one is really cool to kind of change up your photos that you're using for t-shirts or whatever print-on-demand products. And I think this can be really powerful. Try it out. I think sometimes it works really well and sometimes it doesn't, but in this two cases, you can see it worked really well. You can't even tell the flower was there and the butterfly was there. So pretty cool Magic Eraser. All right, so this one is I'm really excited about for kawaii design. So this one is called Translate. So you can automatically translate words to different languages. In this case, I'm going to do Japanese, but you can do any language. Let's do this right now. I'm going to click on mushroom. Well, first, let me show you where to find it. You should see it here, but if you don't, you're going to need to add it. So I added it here to translate. If you have some other ones, like apps, come in here and go into apps and you may find it here and then add it to there. So I already added translate. You can see a bunch of cool stuff here on apps. So I'm gonna do translate. I'm gonna click on this. I'm gonna automatically detect, it's automatically detecting that it's English, I believe. So I'm gonna, you could also put that it's English. So let me do that. So English to Japanese, boom. And it's gonna translate everything on this page, page 4. So I can't individually do it. So it's gonna translate and translate mushroom. But I get to pick a page right here. So page 4, that's what we're on, page 4, and hit translate. Now it's gonna take a little while, well, not that long. And then you can see that's in Japanese. Now I can come in here and then if I don't like this one, I can use a different font. There are some Japanese fonts. So if I just type in here, Japanese, you know, I could pick any one of these and they'll look good. But maybe I want something a little bigger and thicker. I could do that, right? And then I can size it. Of course, it's all text still. And then I can change it. So I'm gonna get rid of this translate here. And then put this here. I'm gonna put effects on it. Maybe do a pink and then, you know, maybe my thickness is like that. Or maybe it's that pink right there. And then, or let's see. Yeah, that pink's fine. Or we could change it to whatever to color it, right? Pretty cool. And then we can change the inside. So let's maybe do that. There you go. So now I have my kawaii design with Japanese text that says mushroom because it translated it. And I can take this and print this as a print-on-demand kawaii design. So very, very cool. I don't have to go to Google Translate anymore and do it. I can do it right into Canva and create all my designs like this. So that would be really good for the different markets too. So if you have a design that you made here in English, you can translate it to German, French, any of those other markets on Amazon too and upload it there. So really cool feature on Canva. Hope to use this a lot for all the different markets. So one more thing to note on this translate is it actually made a separate one. So you can see here I have the English version and it didn't get rid of it. It made a different page, page 5 in the Japanese version. So when you're doing your translate for the different marketplaces on Amazon, you'll just have different pages that it will make and then you can download all of them at once with all transparent backgrounds. And so really cool to scale stuff. So the last feature I wanted to talk about is Magic Write. I'm gonna have to move myself from here because the thing for it here is underneath. So I'm gonna get under here. So this is Magic Write, or at least helps you with Magic Write. So the way I'm gonna use this is kind of like an AI, like a ChatGPT. It's gonna help you write some things. So these, I have some phrases here. It can help you write descriptions. It can help you write bullet points or whatever you need it. I'm gonna use it to help me come up with a phrase for my t-shirts. So let's do this. I wrote some prompts in here just so I can remember what to put in here. So we're gonna do Magic Write. And we're gonna do, we're gonna click on here first. Click on this first, then hit Magic Write. Sorry, jumping ahead. Edit with Magic Write, yes. So I'm gonna edit funny Easter saying. I'm gonna give it a prompt. So I'm gonna say a funny Easter saying with 3 to 5 words. So on a t-shirt. So I'm gonna hit enter and look, I could put this on my t-shirt. Exciting Easter puns. Maybe that's not the best one because I don't wanna use puns, but I could say exciting Easter, right? So this could work for a t-shirt. Really cool. So if you're out of ideas, maybe you want to do a summer vacation. So let's do that. Summer vacation phrase for a t-shirt. Let's see if it understands that. Maybe we do a small. I like to do words. So 2 to 5 word summer vacation phrase. Yeah, there we go. Beach bound, it's 2 words. Yeah, really cool. How about this Cinco de Mayo pun? Let's do that. Let me just do without the 3 to 5 words and see what happens. Oh, it's gonna give me a joke. So I can come back in here and edit that. So let's see. See, that's why I do 3 to 5 words. So 3 to 5 word Cinco de Mayo pun. May the fiesta begin. Perfect. So I can go and change this anytime I want. And this can help you come up with lots of ideas. So we could actually have it do many ideas if we wanted to. So let's do a list of 10, 3 to 5 word phrases for Cinco de Mayo. List of funny, 10 funny, 3 to 5 word phrases, yeah, or puns. Let's do puns, isn't it? Let's see what it is. There we go, look at that. I have 10 of them that I could do. Now, of course, you still have to check if these are trademarked, but you can see it just a brain dump of stuff that you may not be able to think of really quickly. You can do this just like ChatGPT here, built in to Canva to help you with your bullet points, help you with brainstorming, help you with whatever. So have fun using this. I think this can really help speed up what you're designing, and then, you know, use some of these things. I wouldn't even thought of Tequila Mockingbird. That's pretty cool. Have a great time. So some really cool ones for Cinco de Mayo. And then you can find something in here that matches these. So that's my last one, Magic, right? But you can see it's super powerful. The power of AI, kind of ChatGPT stuff built into Canva. So those are the 5 features that I picked from the Canva event. Pretty cool, right? Let me know in the comments which one was your favorite. I think all of those can really help speed up and help with the print-on-demand journey that you guys are on. If you're doing print-on-demand, I think it can help with a lot of stuff. So this is really cool. If you want to go back and watch some more of that, again, you can go watch the full conference and look. There's so many other things, but those are my 5 favorites. Thanks again for watching. If you want to see another video with Canva on how to design in Canva, click on this video right here. I have a whole bunch of Canva design tutorials as well on my channel. Have fun with those. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.